I have multiple goals, all of which are related. As you know, I've dedicated my life to trying to prevent other people from experiencing what I did. So I see this as an outgrowth of that mission. Firstly, I'm concerned with other wrongful conviction cases and other rulings in connection therewith that she could be in position to potentially cast a deciding vote on, which affects the whole country. So that's one thing. The second thing is that, well, kind of related to that, I want to testify at the confirmation hearings and let the senators and the world understand from a first-person point of view what the human costs are of putting procedure over innocence. The third thing is I see this as an opportunity to raise further awareness on a national level about the problem of wrongful convictions and the urgent need for legislation. New York State, the federal government, and many of the other states have not enacted reforms which, well, virtually all the experts agree could make the system more accurate. The idea that she's portrayed as somebody with empathy, somebody that will protect all of our rights, and that she's going to have an even higher level of responsibility. I think from an objective point of view, I think that she should resign, not just decline the nomination, but that she should resign as being a judge. I don't think everybody understands the real life impact of what we're talking about here. She put procedure over justice. We're talking about a man's life. Given that the U.S. Supreme Court very rarely agrees to hear any case, for all intents and purposes, she was my last appeal. She, in effect, condemned me to serve a life sentence in prison for something that I was innocent of, without even ruling on looking at my innocence issue. The bedrock principle of our justice system is supposed to be that innocent people are released and guilty people are punished. That's the intent of the law. So on that level, what she did was not what the law called for. That wasn't the higher purpose of the law. How can anybody, put differently, how can anybody say that dismissing a case on a procedural violation, that's particularly in light of when innocence is argued, that that's justice?